Imagine for a moment that you're living in the 1950s and there's this electric energy filling the air. It's like something out of a movie, but it's real. A young man named Elvis Presley burst onto the scene with his powerful voice and an even more powerful presence. He shook things up, literally and figuratively, and made everyone take notice. But fast forward to the 1960s, and something shocking happens. Elvis, the king himself, seemed to disappear from the stage, and when he did appear, it was on a big screen, often in movies that, well, let's just say they weren't his best work. How did this happen? Let's dive into the story of Elvis' journey, from his early success to the campy movies, and uncover the reasons behind this wild ride. Elvis, fresh from his army days, was eager to make a mark in the entertainment industry. However, his first movie post-army left him unhappy. He felt the material was lacking, and he soon realized that he had little control over the direction of his film career. It seemed like a strange twist for someone who had captivated audiences with his music and stage presence. One of Elvis' early films, G.I. Blues, saw him play a singing soldier stationed in Germany. Elvis, known for his raw and powerful performances, felt out of place in this movie. He complained to his then-girlfriend, Priscilla, about having to sing on screen, feeling it was ridiculous and not true to his artistic vision. Despite his discomfort, the movie was a success, with the soundtrack reaching number one and receiving Grammy nominations. The public loved it, but Elvis was not satisfied. Elvis' dissatisfaction with G.I. Blues set the tone for what was to come. Between 1960 and 1961, he starred in two more dramatic movies, Flaming Star and Wild in the Country, which had a more mature tone and fewer singing scenes. While these movies were well-received critically, they didn't perform as well financially as his earlier, more musical films. This led to a significant shift in Elvis' career. The studios, noticing the financial success of his musical movies, decided to focus on that formula. Elvis' next movie, Blue Hawaii, became a massive hit. It was a musical film with a successful soundtrack to match. The studio, seeing the financial gains, felt they had a winning formula. From that point on, Elvis was typecast as a singing actor, often playing characters like singing cowboys, fighters, or doctors. It was a decision that would impact his career for years to come. One of the most surprising aspects of Elvis' 1960s journey is the halt to his live performances. The same man who had captivated audiences with his raw energy and powerful voice seemed to vanish from the stage. Fans could only see him in movies, and his live performances became a rare occurrence. In fact, between his army induction in 1958 and his comeback in 1968, Elvis gave only a handful of live shows, all for charitable causes. On March 25, 1961, Elvis gave a performance that showcased his true talent and passion. It was a benefit concert to raise funds for the USS Arizona Memorial in Pearl Harbor. The concert was a massive success, with fans paying top to see their idol. Elvis, despite feeling out of practice, delivered an amazing performance. This concert, a rare glimpse of Elvis in his element, raised over $64,000, and a year later, the memorial was completed. Elvis, despite his success in the movies, yearned for more challenging and artistic roles. In an interview in 1962, he expressed his desire for better scripts and more mature roles. He felt that with experience, he could deliver powerful performances that would do justice to his talent. However, the studios seemed reluctant to move away from the formula that was bringing in the big bucks. As Elvis' movie roles became more campy, his music took a hit as well. While there were some great songs that emerged from movie soundtracks, like Return to Sender and Can't Help Falling in Love, there were also some questionable choices. Songs like Fort Lauderdale Chamber of Commerce and Song of the Shrimp left fans wondering if Elvis had lost his touch. Elvis himself was disappointed with some of the material, feeling it didn't match his artistic vision. In the midst of all the campy movies and questionable songs, Elvis took a bold step and recorded his first full album of gospel music, His Hand in Mine. It was a risky move, especially during the height of his career, but Elvis was passionate about religious music. He saw it as a tribute to his mother and a way to connect with his spiritual side. The album peaked at number 3 on the charts, proving that Elvis could still deliver powerful and meaningful music. Despite the success of His Hand in Mine, Elvis faced a long drought in terms of number 1 singles. From 1962 to 1968, there was a gap in his chart-topping hits. It was a challenging time for Elvis, but he persisted. Finally, in 1968, Suspicious Minds hit the top of the charts, signaling a comeback and a renewed interest in his music. Elvis' journey through the 1960s is a story of resilience and perseverance. Despite being typecast and feeling dissatisfied with his work, he continued to deliver powerful performances both on screen and on stage. His passion for music and his commitment to his fans kept him going. Even when the studios seemed to focus more on profit than artistic merit, Elvis never gave up on his desire for better roles and more meaningful music. As we reflect on Elvis' journey, we see a man who, despite facing challenges and feeling restricted, never lost his connection with his fans. His live performances, though rare, were powerful reminders of his talent. And while some of his movies and songs may be seen as less memorable, Elvis' impact on music and popular culture remains undeniable. He is a symbol of resilience, a reminder that true artists can persevere and that sometimes the most memorable moments happen when we least expect them. So, as we conclude this journey through Elvis' story, we are left with a sense of awe and inspiration. It's a reminder that even in the face of adversity, we can find our true selves and make an impact. Elvis' story is a testament to the power of passion and the resilience of the human spirit.